Thank you for my presentation and for this opportunity. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Gabriella Maselli. I'm a PhD from the Department of Civil Engineering of the University of Salerno. And this work concerns the characterization of economic analysis models for cleaner production investment. In particular, in this work conducted with Professor Antonio Nestico, the focus is on the critical issue related to the cost-benefit analysis for environmental projects, and in particular for the estimation on the critical parameters of the cost-benefit analysis, that is the social discount rate. There is a problem. Okay. In the last year, growing environmental issues are driving more and more the search for new technologies, policies based on cleaner production, and more in general, green projects. The aim is, in particular, to accelerate the transition toward the Sustainable Development Goals. And among these projects, we can mention, for instance, project in energy field, intervention on water resources, or intervention that jointly use energy and water resources in the framework on water energy nexus, but also and again, urban forestry intervention, urban planning program, and so on. But what are the main features, the main characteristics of these projects? First of all, these projects generate strong environmental and social externalities on the territory and on the community and on the territory in which the project is located. And in particular, very often these effects occur over the long and the very long term. So it is very important that these externalities that be translated in a monetary term must be correctly estimated and included in the cost-benefit analysis, because the correct consideration of these externalities, it is very important to preserve future generations. And what is the example of environmental externalities? Improvement of our air quality, it impacts variation in greenhouse gas emission, and so on. And very difficult is correctly consider in monetary term these effects. So in this framework, it is very important, very urgent to characterize a new economic model for the assessment these action and strategies. And in this context, the cost-benefit analysis plays an important role. And this is because many guidelines and the government imposes to implement cost-benefit analysis in order to express an economic judgment on the intervention. And in particular, the result of cost-benefit analysis is very important because it is necessary to build a priority list to the of the intervention to be financed. So it is very important, a critical issue is the choice of a social discount rate, because this parameter of cost-benefit analysis significantly affects the outcome of a cost-benefit test. And can we see the choice of a social discount rate can guide policymaking towards more sustainable investment choices. But what is the means of this parameter? First of all, the social discount rate allow us to attribute a weight to cost and benefit that an investment generate in time in order to render to in order to make cost and benefit comparable from an economic point of view. So the result of the cost-benefit test can be expressed by an indicator, the net present value that we can see in this slide. And this parameter, it is a function of benefit and cost that the project generates in each time. And in particular, net present value is a function of the social discount rate, because the cost and the benefit that the project generates in each time are discounted in order to make them comparable. And the first step is to add this cash flow discounting. So it is important to underline that the result of the cost-benefit test expresses by net present value increase sorry decrease when the time increases and when the value of a social discount rate increases that this is shown in this table. And in particular, we can see that the higher the discount rate, the less value is assigned to the future savings in today's decisions. Usually, the government and the guideline suggests the use of a constant discount rate. In other terms, a discount rate that is constant in time. And in this case, as the time horizon increases, project costs and benefit are underestimated. Some government and in some cases also declining the discount rate are implemented and are proposed. And in the second case, with a time declining structure of a discount rate, we have that as time increases, the effect of discounting on the cost and the benefit is smaller. And in other terms, more importance, more weight is given to the future cost and future benefit of the project. But from our point of view, also the use of a declining structure doesn't solve the problem related to the discounting. So with this research, we intend to propose an innovative economic and environmental discounting in which environmental externalities are weighed with a different and lower discount rate than the discount rate used for financial cash flow. And in particular, the aim is to distinguish between intragenerational environmental project or the project with the short-term effect and intergenerational environmental project or a project with a longer-term effect. So in the first case, we propose a dual discounting approach that use environmental discount rate and economic discount rate, but these discount rate are constant in time. In the second case, or in the case of environmental project with long-term effect, we propose a dual discounting approach. But in this approach, the two functions of a discount rate, economic and environmental discount rate, are time declining. And in particular, the novelty is the introduction of the mathematical structure of a social discount rate on the environmental quality that is in particular a function of the environmental performance index. What is the basic assumption of the model? First of all, this model that is based on Ramsey formula and Golier model, the function of social welfare depends both on consumption and environmental quality. The environment deteriorates over time, and the consumption and environmental quality are correlated by a specific function. In this way, we can obtain two different functions. The first one for the estimation of consumption or a discount rate, and the second function for the estimation of environmental quality discount rate. And it is possible to see that both the formulas depend by environmental variables, such as the elasticity of environmental quality to change in consumption, and for example, the degree of aversion to environmental risk. And other parameters that are economic, such as the growth rate of consumption of the income disparity risk aversion. In this slide, we summarize the formulas using deriving from the literature in order to estimate each of the parameter of the two formulas. And well, here we enter into detail of the two model. In this case, we can see the main steps of the first model or the model for the intragenerational project. And in this case, we introduce a specific environmental index in the mathematical structure of a social discount rate. And in particular, we define the environmental quality as a function of environmental performance index. This index ranks a lot of countries on 24 performance indicators across 10 issue categories that cover environmental health and ecosystem vitality. And in particular, this environmental performance index allows us to establish how close countries are to achieving the sustainable development goals. And the focus is in particular of the elasticity of environmental quality to change in consumption, because we correlate the environmental performance index with the gross domestic product per capita of each country. And from the correlation between these two variables, we derive this parameter that affect significantly the result of the implementation of the model. This is a focus on the second model or the model for discounting to be used in order to evaluate intergenerational project or project with a long-term effect. What is the difference between with respect to the previous model? Also, in this case, we define environmental quality as a function of environmental performance index. But we introduce a macroeconomic risk in the mathematical formulation, and in particular, we model the growth rate of consumption as an uncertain variable. And in this way, we can forecast a probability distribution of the two discount rate. And in this way, we can estimate the two discount rate function that the decline over time in order to give more weight to the long-term effect. In this slide, we summarize the main steps for the implementation of the second model. The two models are implemented with the reference to different economies. First of all, the model is implemented with respect to the China economy, and the model implemented with the reference of the Italian economics. And we obtain that the values of the discount rate to be used in the analysis of intergenerational project for Italy are very lower with respect to the result obtained for China. In fact, for Italy, economic discount rate is about 3%, and environmental discount rate for Italy is about 1.7%. While for China, the two discount rate are respectively 9.8% and 3.4%. And this difference is linked, first of all, to the higher gross domestic product of China. But it is very important to underline the difference between the two discount rate for the China, and it is related to the environmental performance of the specific country. The similar results are obtained also with the reference of the second model. In this case, the second model return the time declining term structure of social di of discount rate for Italy and for China. The results are very similar to the result obtained with the previous model. And in particular, it is very important to underline all the for China the difference between the two rates is very high, but the two function decline very rapidly with respect to the Italian case. And this means that is very important to attribute more importance to environmental effect early in the first years of the analysis. This table show the result of economic plan of a generic project in which the net present value is estimated with two different approach. In the first case, the constant discount rate is used, and in the second case, the net present value is estimated for the two countries using the dual and discounting approach and using the value that we have estimated. And it is very important to underline how in the second case the net present value in both cases is very higher with the reference to the first case, and because in the first case we have underestimated the environmental effect both in the short and in the long term. So, what is the aim of this research? With this research, we propose a discounting approach for a project with environmental effect, and we distinguish between intergenerational and intragenerational projects. The model were implemented with different economies, Italian economics and Chinese economics. And the two functions of the discount rate for China start from higher initial values than for Italy, but decline much more rapidly from the early years of the analysis period. So, in conclusion, the application shows how a different discount rate can be estimated in the relation to the environmental socio-economic context. And in particular, the use of estimated discount rate can favor more sustainable investment choices in line with the climate neutrality objectives. So, from our point of view, governments should update proposed discount rate, estimating the specific value of this parameter in relation to the investment sector and depending of the on the project time horizon. So, in summary, the repercussions on environmental decision making deriving from this consideration are therefore very important and evident. Thank you for attention.